I've been testing 308 ammunition on ballistics gel at 100 yards, and this is next in the line. This is the Nosler Accubond bullet here. Now, this ammunition isn't made anymore, unfortunately. This is from Ammo Inc. This is American Hunter, but this is still gonna be a really good test bed for the Accubond. This is designed to fly very efficiently through the air with that plastic tip that you see right there, and then when it hits, it's supposed to rapidly expand, make that giant flower o' death with all of its cutting petals, tear through the animal, tear up whatever organs are in there, and then hopefully, since this is bonded construction, it's gonna retain that weight, and you have a pretty good chance of getting an exit wound on the other side. So let's go take this on 20% gel at 100 yards and see how it does.
This is a Stevens Model 200 action with a 308 Savage barrel on it, just a little 22 incher. And sitting on top, we have a Horus Hover, 5-20x50. That felt good. Okay. That was a nice, clean, easy eject. And that was 2,665 feet per second. These are moving out pretty good. Okay, that one went up and left a little bit. 2,687 feet per second. That's about 20 feet per second faster than that first one. Okay, that puts them right down with the other group, 2,733 feet per second. All right, that's a pretty decent group down just below the bullseye and a little left. We really only have one flyer. That was, let's see, that last one was 2,678 feet per second. Let's see how that bonded construction holds up against 20% gel. This is not the stuff that I was shooting last year. I was shooting 10% then, which is more like pig flesh. This is more like deer flesh. I think that one might be a little too close to the edge TLR. We'll go down range and take a look.
The Accubond trail opens up at about 2.25 inches, and it creates a very wide path that keeps going until we get to about the, oh, that's about the 13 inch mark. So this is cutting a very wide path. And this is going to be all of that wonderful organ meat that this is going through and turning it all into soup. This tracked pretty straight and true. You can see that it curved off just a little bit, but then it ended up right back here at about 19 inches of penetration. And you can see that it held together really well. I don't see any significant chunks of lead. There is a little bit in there, some little chunks like this one. And I think that's actually a bullet tip down there. But really, it seems to have held together really well, and it has come to rest as one neat mushroom all the way back here. This should be retaining almost all of its original weight. This track at its widest opens up to about 1.75 inches, and remember that this is 20% gel, not 10%. So this is going to put up a bigger fight. The fact that we get such a huge temporary wound cavity and this huge permanent one as well is just a really good testament to the performance of the Nosler Accubond bullet. This is something that is going to work really well in heavier game as well as lighter game. The recovered Accubond has a maximum width over 3/4 inch across. And just look at that front face. You have all these cutting petals that caused all the damage earlier, and these are sharp. Let's see how much weight we have retained. We're looking at nearly 140 grains, so we lost just a little bit over 10 grains of its original weight. And that's that bonded construction for you. Thanks a bunch for watching, you guys. Make sure that you check out the other videos on the way. We have the Deer Season XP, and we have M80 Ball, 7.62 by 51. Plus, we're going to be using some of these in an AR-10, a short AR-10, a little 16-incher, out at close ranges and at long range as well to see how they perform. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you guys around.
Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, be sure to like, share, and most importantly, subscribe. Even if you didn't like this particular content, go ahead and subscribe. There's probably something coming that's more up your alley. Check out this playlist right here. This is going to have videos in a similar vein to what you just watched. These two videos we cherry-picked for you. And finally, The Social Regressive is on Patreon. So, you can become a patron of the Destructive Arts and earn some goodies while helping us to provide high-quality videos just by kicking us a few bucks a month. Thanks a bunch for your patronage.